Yeah, college town, back to school, Rodney Dangerfield. And I love these college towns. When you get older, move to a college town, man. It's like, you don't feel old while you're there. These young, cute girls. Good ass pizza. I just got a juice made at this juice place. $10. Beet juice, bunch of other stuff in it. It's good. Gonna be healthier now. This is Prince Avenue, like a main area north of campus. It's a killer seafood place right there. Square One. Right there. This is good. All these college towns look alike. Illinois, Kentucky, Ann Arbor, Wisconsin. They're all the same. See a lot of college kids up here. Piedmont, I just went to that hospital. It was good. I really enjoyed it. Good, friendly people. A lot of joggers. Flying Biscuit, I went there when I first moved here. That was good too. People out having fun, Popeyes. Yeah, I cut down to the back way. So I would be in the north section of Athens. Just north of campus, pretty much. Gonna make my way down a little east, a little south and east. Figured I'd get by the college campus. Pretty out here, beautiful. Spring is here. Oh, 15's here? Oh yeah, let's kick it. Dunkin' Donuts, taco stand. There's a sushi place around here too. That's good too. See how the houses are though? They're all kind of alike. There's a guy painting this house color mine. It's weird. I was up there a couple years ago when I first moved here. You know, it's up ahead. Couldn't have been 2 years ago. Must have been 1 year ago, because I remember that I interviewed that black guy. And I asked him his opinion, and he thought I said sexual position. Stupid fucker. Who the hell think I'd be asking about a sexual opinion position during an interview? All these towns remind me of one another, which is good. They're all expensive. They all have the same stuff. I'm shitting you. Design of the houses, the little knick-knack shops. I mean, is this the college kids that bring that, or the businesses that show up, then the college, or vice versa, or what? Only little knock down here is it's hotter than hell in the summer. It's kind of like that everywhere. Pray for Athens. Yeah, you know, they had a girl murdered up here, you know, a couple weeks ago, unfortunately. You know, and another thing, I talk to these people up here when I'm, like, waiting for my pizzas now. And everywhere I am, like, a young person is working. They're going to college here. And that just isn't quite that way in Ann Arbor. They're like hardly ever going to college there. It's weird. They're just working there. But anyway, I've never talked to anybody. Look at all the beautiful flowers. I've never talked to anybody that didn't absolutely love going to school here. mean, they all just don't want it to end. Rodney Dangerfield, back to school. That's an apartment complex, by the way. But that's, I'd like to do something like that. That is really beautiful. I'd like to talk to whoever did that. That is a lot of nice flowers. Yeah. Beautiful Somerville, South Village. God, is that pretty. Good looking girls everywhere. My God. Live here, no problem. I come up here all the time. You know, the only thing too, I've looked for lectures places, you know, I could go and sit on lectures and stuff, but I really haven't found any. They're not like publicized well. They had an entomology thing in Augusta today, but it was like college kids. I go different ways when I'm here. Different ways home. I never come down through this way too much. This Georgia Revival design over there. I love the architecture down here, the southern architecture. It's so practical, no wasted space. Like instead of just a second story with a roof, they got like a little like, what do they call that? Dormer almost. Leaded windows, stained glass, but with clear in the middle, so if you were a kid, you could still go up there and look out. I'll tell you another thing too. I really got out of collecting things. Work on my mental illness. Just got out of certain things that just I devoted too much time to. Just obsessed with collecting things. Now I just collect knowledge. You know, I want to just collect. Information about things, not a bunch of junk in different rooms. There's a couple mistakes they made on my shelves too. I'm going to talk to that guy about this week. And I think he might have fucked up my reverse osmosis. Not sure. I'm going to find out. Oh my God, gorgeous. These girls are so beautiful. What am I complaining about looking at these good college girls? I could have a 68-year-old any day, overweight, out of shape, ex-smoker. Fuck. I'm not exactly sure where this road's gonna come out. But I know it's gotta come out close to where I'm going. Say lost, but I don't know why I haven't hit Washington yet. Grass, I'm gonna have to start cutting the grass next week. And I only got 4 hours sleep last night. You know, I got up this morning, nice day. It's like this daylight saving time. I thought, ah, shit, I'll just stay up. I was at Barnes & Noble an hour away when they opened. Well, actually, I wasn't. I was an hour late. So it was 11 instead of 10. dipped it. That's it. I bought a good book. Back that I was saying, so anyway, I didn't sell everything like I normally do, because a guy wanted to buy all that shit, lowballed me, and then he said he wanted one of the, I don't want to lie about anything, you know, and I collected myself, so let's say for an example, you get a hold of this documentation, 1860s to 1920. If you're a collector, okay, you want it all if you can possibly get it. You know what I mean? Oh, look where I'm at here. And you, the guy said he wanted only one of the books out of all those letterheads, and I just didn't want to do it. Not because it wasn't like a good idea or something. You know, I'm trying to negotiate. It was, I don't want the next collector coming around that wants this stuff, which is historically relevant, and them saying, is this all of it? And I'm forced to, like, either not tell the truth, which I'm not going to do, or kind of fuck this guy or girl out of a complete set of documentation in a specific area that I got a hold of. You know, nobody wants the group with the missing book. So I said, no, I can't, I'm not doing that, man. Which is probably why I'm not too good at this either, and I hate selling stuff. Because I know I'm almost like looking out for the other guy. You know? Crazy. Shortchanged on a nice group of paperwork. That's it. Now I'm feeling a little better, man. I was so damn tired. Fell asleep in my car in Barnes & Noble parking lot. Checked on the vultures. I haven't seen any vultures flying around lately. It's kind of weird. Straighter south into 70 Washington before I was this far east, and it didn't. I mean, I kind of knew where I was. Didn't matter. I'd just be kicking it, you know what I'm saying? Beautiful day here. Past the college part now. And they're doing construction around here. They don't seem to ever be close to being done. I really don't get it. This is taking forever.
Thank you.
kick it. Thank you. kick it, you know what I'm saying? You get some new shoes? trap here. Single. He's not from around here. He'd have taken that little turn out. You can't see when you're in something big like that looking to the right. Just kick it. Sustainable pine tree growing. Just kick it, you know what I'm saying? up here to the left, they just cleared this. God knows what it cost. Looks like carpet now. They had some of the coolest equipment. Big ass, those six tire tractors. There's three of them there. These big triple weighted things. Big giant dozers. Sometimes it's 3 months where I see him. Equipment auction, March 16th, Woodbine Ag Center. Kick it. Vulture's up in the tree. Bet she's hungry. You hungry? Hey girl. Hey girl, you hungry?